Hi, this is Dr. Jeff Junig from addictionremission.com. I'll ask you to bear with me as I try out different names and logos and whatnot. What I would like to do, as I've said before, is develop a question and answer format here. And ideally, I would have it in a way that it would run ads through YouTube. And when you run ads on YouTube, when you try to monetize a site, there are many things that will not get approved for advertising. And so I'm trying to figure out what will get approved and what won't get approved. My suspicion is that brand names of medications will not get approved. And so I'm going to try to avoid brand names of medications and stick to generic names of medications. I'm also going to try to stick to science. And avoid a lot of conjecture. And when I do use conjecture, meaning when I do just make guesses about things, I'll try to specify that so that people know that I'm guessing, to trust that part of my opinion a little bit less significantly. I will just say too, my training is in this area, meaning in psychiatry, addiction, opioids. As far as my background goes, I have a PhD in neurochemistry, worked on receptor binding studies. Then I went to medical school, became an anesthesiologist. I worked for a number of years, about 10 years, as an anesthesiologist and as a pain treatment physician before becoming addicted to opioids. Initially through cough medicine, progressing to the real hard stuff, and went through treatment, a significant monitoring program as part of the medical board's requirements. And now I treat people using buprenorphine for opioid dependence. When I say buprenorphine, I'm talking about all the forms of buprenorphine. There's a form called Suboxone, there's a form called Zubsolv, there's form called Subutex. They all work about the same. And again, because I would like to be able to monetize these sites, I'm going to try to talk about these things using generic names. What else can I tell you here? I would like to get questions from people. Again, as I've mentioned before, we had this set up on a different site where people would ask questions. It was at thefix.com, and I would provide an answer. It worked very well, so feel free to leave a question in your comments. What I thought I'd just mention briefly today, I was looking through some of the other videos about this topic. This topic meaning opioid dependence and buprenorphine. And I notice a number of sites where people are trying to taper off the medication. And it's interesting looking at these series of videos where people look horrible for a stretch of time and then look good after a period of time. And then in some cases, they just disappear. And I don't know, what that means. I'm hoping it means they're doing well. I'm sure it doesn't always mean that, but hopefully, at least most of the time, the person is doing well. But something I saw today that I thought was worth mentioning was a person who had gone out 2 months without taking anything and was saying that she was feeling much better, but having a number of crises in her life that she was attributing to the buprenorphine she had been on 2 months earlier. She said that she figured that her own neurochemistry must be screwed up, and so she was still waiting for that to get better. And then later a video was out about 4 months or so, and she was saying that she was dealing with post-acute withdrawal and felt that her chemistry was still messed up. Some comments about that idea. When people are addicted to any substance, or behavior for that matter, what happens is they become very one-dimensional. They focus entirely on the object of their addiction. If it's an opiate, you know, every 4 hours, where is it going to come from? How are they going to keep from getting sick? If it's not that, it's who found out what I did? You know, am I in trouble with this person or that person? Where am I going to get the money to cover this bill or that bill? Those are the concerns of a person dealing with active addiction. When you take that person and you put them into remission from addiction using any treatment, whether it's meetings or a medication such as buprenorphine or buprenorphine naloxone or Vivitrol, which is naltrexone, when you treat the addiction, one of the things that happens is they no longer are focused on just this one thing and repressing everything else. So now they are experiencing life, all of the things that they never worried about, you know, things like paying their electric bill, things like where am I going to sleep tomorrow night, and then getting into more complex things like do I really like my boyfriend or not? Is my son going to grow up to be, you know, a good guy? Is my mother doing okay? You know, people who are addicted, many times those issues are second in line to the primary concern, which is I can't be sick. I cannot be sick. If I'm sick, I can't be a mom. I can't, you know, work. I can't function. So I cannot be sick. What happens then as people get out a ways from using, they meet a lot of chaos. In meetings, 12-step meetings, they refer to it as meeting life on life's terms. Suddenly, they are dealing with life without something repressing all of those things. They are dealing with life on life's terms. And so the person in this video is talking about having all these mood swings. You know, mood swings are normal. You know, for sober people, mood swings happen. You know, they happen. You know, you get a phone call and you hear good news and you're happy. You get a phone call then and you hear bad news and you're sad. I mean, mood swings are life. And as a 50-year-old, you know, trust me, it doesn't get all that much easier as you go forward. In fact, things start to have greater importance to them and affect other people besides ourselves, and things get more complicated. So the pressures on our mood become even greater. And so what a person has to learn if they're going to be sober, or, you know, by sober I mean on medication, off medication, whatever, they have to learn to tolerate feelings. They just have to learn what their way is, whether they take up meditation, whether they use exercise, whether they become Buddhist, whether they become a Christian, you know, something that is their specific way to deal with life on life's terms. And again, in this, I don't know the person who left this video, but my thought when I saw it was, I didn't think she probably 4 months out was dealing with post-acute withdrawal or neurochemical imbalances. Our body is very good at clearing out neurochemical imbalances. I mean, that's what everything in our body is designed to do, is to create stable homeostasis, normal chemical conditions, especially in the brain where chemicals really can cause changes in the way that nerve cells act and signal each other. So chemical imbalance, not so much. But I think what probably is going on is that the person has these unconscious things, meaning things that the person hasn't really thought about, but that the unconscious mind is constantly thinking about and dealing with. Those unconscious things will pull our mood in different directions, will cause us to feel stressed or anxious, and I think that that's a very important part of sobriety for people to recognize, and one of the main parts of sobriety. What I'd like to talk about next in another video, I'm going to talk about ways to identify your feelings and make sense of them, ways to tolerate life on life's terms for people who are no longer using chemicals to do that. The other thing I want to talk about is the unconscious mind and how the unconscious mind interacts with our conscious mind, how those different parts of our mind interact with each other to create psychiatric symptoms or moods or feelings. You know, as always, I am a board certified psychiatrist. I'm a board certified anesthesiologist. I'm a scientist in neuroscience with a PhD in that area. I feel well qualified to talk about these things. I cannot work as someone's doctor when I don't know the person. So as always, anything I say here is intended to provoke discussion between you and your physician, between you and your friend, or just for your own interest. But please do not use me to make treatment decisions, because that really requires knowing you, which I don't. I will check for questions in my inbox, so feel free to ask away. I'm going to call myself Addiction Remission just because I own that URL. I have a logo that looks pretty cool. And so you may see that that logo is kind of blood red with some other pictures on it at the start of my videos. I'm still experimenting. Please subscribe if this is an area that interests you, and I am going to try to commit to be in here. Thank you very much.